Now the festival of unleavened bread, called the Passover, was approaching, and the chief priests and the teachers of the law were looking for some way to get rid of Jesus, for they were afraid of the people. Then Satan entered Judas, called Iscariot, one of the 12. And Judas went to the chief priests and the officers of the temple guard and discussed with them how he might betray Jesus. They were delighted and agreed to give him money. He consented and watched for an opportunity to hand Jesus over to them when no crowd was present. When evening came, Jesus was reclining at the table with the 12. And as they were eating, Jesus took bread, blessed and broke it, and gave it to the disciples and said,
"Take this bread and eat. It's my body."
Then he took the cup and gave thanks and gave it to them, saying,
"This is my blood of a new covenant, which is shed for all for the forgiveness of sins. Drink, all of you. Do this in remembrance of me. And one of you will betray me."
"Betray you?
Master, I know it's not me. It's probably John."
"It has to be Peter."
"It's definitely not
me."
"Why must you argue over who the most important person is at the table? Listen to me. You should not seek power or fame in this world. Who is greater? The one that sits at the table or the one that serves? I have come to serve."
So Jesus got up from the meal and took off his outer clothes. He wrapped a towel around his waist. After that, he poured water into a large bowl. Then he began to wash his disciples' feet.
"Wash my feet? Why? That makes no sense."
"It's important that I set the example. That who is better than I?"
"I mean, he was the Messiah, not some servant to perform some type of menial labor. I told Jesus I didn't want him to wash my feet. But he insisted, said it was necessary."
They went to a place called Gethsemane, and Jesus said to his disciples, "Sit here while I pray."
"This is possible. Let this cup pass by me. But let your will be done, not mine."
When Jesus returned, we had fallen asleep. When he had came back again, I have to admit, we were snoring. He had woke us up, and we were at a loss for words. I mean, what could we say?
"He said to me, 'Simon, couldn't you just watch for an hour?' He told us to pray, and he warned us not to fall into temptation. He knew we wanted to be there for him, but our bodies, we were just too weak."
Jesus had been praying, and he came to wake us up for a third time. Couldn't even stay awake. He was so frustrated with us. That was the time where he really needed us, and we couldn't be there for him. We tried to stay awake, but our eyes were just so heavy.
So next thing you know, here comes Judas with this determined look on his face, leading a crowd of people, and they had weapons. It was ridiculous. I'd never seen him like that before. He walked right up to Jesus, and he kissed him. Apparently, that was the sign to have him arrested. So, of course, I drew my sword. I even cut off the ear of one of the soldiers. But Jesus, he told me to put my sword away."
He didn't try to run. He didn't try to escape. He knew he was to go alone. He was trying to protect us. So he told them that he was Jesus of Nazareth and told them to let us go.
"Did what I was hired to do. I knew he'd be in the Garden of Gethsemane praying. That was one of his favorite places. So we just waited for him. I knew he couldn't be protected. He didn't have a crowd around him. That's when we got him.
Now the chief priests and the whole council were seeking false testimony against Jesus that they might put him to death. At last, they found one.
Well, I heard this Jesus say that he could destroy the temple of God and rebuild it in 3 days.
What is this testimony that has been brought to me before this council by these men stating that you are going to destroy the temple? Have you nothing to say for yourself? I order you under oath to tell us that you are the Messiah, the Son of the Living God.
I am the Son of God, and you will see me sitting at the right hand of God, ascending from the clouds of heaven.
How dare he speak to me in that way? And I told the crowd, we don't need any more witnesses. You've heard this blasphemy. What is it that you want me to do?
Now Peter was sitting out in the courtyard, and a servant girl came to him.
Hey, don't I know you? Haven't I seen you before? You were with Jesus, weren't you? I have seen you before. He's one of them.
Why couldn't I bring myself to say that I knew the man? I would have given my life for him, I swear it. The sound of that rooster, it still haunts me.
Then the Jewish leaders took Jesus from Caiaphas to the palace of Pilate, the Roman governor. By now, it was early morning, and to avoid ceremonial uncleanliness, they did not enter the palace because they wanted to be able to eat the Passover.
You see, they brought him to me and I asked him, I said, why are you bringing this man to me? And what are the charges? These Jewish leaders, they were insisting that I charge Jesus and have him crucified because he claims to be the king of the Jews. So I asked Jesus, I wanted to know, why would your own people turn on you like this? So, tell us all, are you the king of the Jews?
I am a king, but not of this world. Therefore, I was born into this world to testify to the truth. Those that listen to me,
I still had no real reason to kill him. But in the end, I gave him Jesus. I did what I could do.
When Judas, who had betrayed him, saw that Jesus was condemned, he was seized with remorse.
I sinned. Oh God, forgive me. Please forgive me. After I saw what they did to Jesus, I didn't want that money. I took the 30 pieces of silver and I threw it at them, and I ran out of the temple. My sins were too great. I don't deserve to live.
Thank you. after God gave you the power to perform so many miracles? Why can't you save yourself?
So you were gonna destroy the temple, huh? And rebuild it in 3 days? Look at you! You're pathetic!
My son! I can't bear to see you like this. But I'm here, baby. I'm here to offer you a face of love. Remember when I thought I lost you in the temple? Oh, how we searched. And then when I found you, you just leaped into my arms. I can't believe they're doing this to you. You did nothing. Nothing but love them. And I can't do anything. I can't do anything, can I? There's nothing that anyone can do but watch.